great players, because over the last 3 years, if you look close enough, there's some gray hair going on because of you guys. So thank you guys at just 33. So no, all kidding aside, first thing I want to talk about, obviously, is how proud I am of our football team. And you know, you don't often say that about a team that hasn't had much success, but you know, it's been a very up and down 3 years, or 2.5 years, I would say. And just the fact that we've got, I really feel like a lot of these coaches have said today that we've got a great group of guys coming back that have really stuck through the fire. There's been Saturdays that have been very, very low, I know for me as a coach, but also for our players as well. There's been some Saturdays that have been pretty high. You know, more often than not, it's been that lower side because we all want to win. But, you know, I'm really proud of the guys that have stuck it out and have, you know, it's really easy to be a part of something when it's going right. It's a lot harder to be a part of something when it's not going right all the time. So I just want to say that. We've only have 6 seniors coming back this year, so we're a relatively young team. It's the oldest team that we've had since I've been at Capital, which is encouraging. But hopefully we can lean on those senior leaders that talk about a group of guys that really have gone through some things as a football player. And personally, I've been through some of those seasons as a player. I know it's not easy to continue to press on. So I just want to give a shout-out to our seniors. As we go into 2015. We're going to be somewhat young again, like I said, but the good thing is, I think it was Stacy that you know, listening to him talk, and Andy, I feel like we were in very similar situations 2.5 years ago, and we still are. As, you know, it takes time to build a program, and but it is nice to look at the depth chart and see some sophomores, juniors, and seniors. We're not counting on any freshmen necessarily to come in right now to a blank spot to take the field for us. Hopefully some of those guys will come in and compete, but I feel really good about those upperclassmen that are coming back. Offensively, you know, obviously we like to run the football, as everybody knows. We've got Brent Walton here today, who's a 1,000-yard rusher. I think he's our first 1,000-yard rusher since 2009. Led us to a number 7 ranking in the nation on the ground, and 2-sport athlete, so even more incredible. Led our lacrosse team to a league championship this past spring, so he's a winner, knows how to get it done. We're counting on that leadership to carry over some more onto the football field and lead our offense. You know, we've got 4 guys, really 5, that played last year on the offensive line, and mostly juniors, 1 sophomore. So in the middle of it all is Will Weir. He's in the feature article in the OAC guide there, with you on your table there, and he's a guy that started this going into his 3rd year starting. He started as a freshman, and he makes all our calls up front like most centers do, and is a really good leader for us there. Got a couple receivers back. Jake Skelton, a senior. Zach Wyatt, a senior. Look for big things from them on the edge. They obviously have to block for what we do a lot, but they're selfless guys and are ready to take advantage of opportunities that come their way. We have 4 slot backs that have played a substantial amount. Corey Heater, Nick Waters, and then Jake Brakey and Wally Brewer, or Wally and Jake, are both seniors. So, quarterback position, if you remember anything about us last year, we had a guy here, Chase Longwell, who was a sophomore. Well, game 2, he tore his ACL and meniscus, was out all season, and he actually unfortunately re-tore it in February, slipped on ice. So, Daryl, I understand the snow comment too. I'm from Florida. They didn't tell me much about that either when I took the job. So, but he slipped on ice. But he's a great guy. He's going to come back and help us coach a little bit. So my point is being, we have 2 sophomores that have played for us last year that are coming back. They're going to battle it out for that quarterback position, which we're excited about because last 2 years we started freshmen for the most part of that position. On defense, we've got some holes to fill. We lost a few guys. Jimmy Curtis is here with us today. He's our leading tackler at safety. We're going to move him around a little bit. And he's, you know, one of those guys, he's a little older, he's going to be a junior this year, has some experience, transferred to our program last year, and he's just one of those guys that takes care of business. And he goes out, he's an example for everybody else to follow, so we're looking forward to him spearheading that side of the ball. You have another couple seniors on that side of the ball. Vince Austin is a defensive lineman. Aaron Biscount was a transfer as well 2 years ago as a senior. And our linebacker spot is pretty wide open. One more guy in the secondary is Joe Rodriguez. He started for us at safety. So we look pretty good in the back end. Need to fill some corner positions. Linebackers are going to be young and up front. We had a lot of guys play, but a lot of injuries last year. So we're going to look to hopefully establish some of those guys in camp. But as everybody said today, you know, this is a great time of year, right? The expectations are high. Everybody wants to win. And we're no different than anybody else in this room. So I'm most proud of our guys growing, and it's been neat to see that growth in our players and myself as a coach over the last 3 years. So hopefully we continue to grow as a program, and that's going to start showing up on the scoreboard for us. We trust that it will. We've also had some coaching changes on our staff as well, which I think are going to be great additions for our staff. And we're hoping that 2015 is going to be a great year for Cowboys football. So I appreciate you guys being here today and letting us